Okay, now we are discussing how to assign the superclass object to a subclass object to a superclass. See what is it? Superclass variable can references subclass object. That is, the reference variable of a superclass can be assigned to a reference variable to subclass derived from that superclass. Next, what is the condition when a reference to a subclass object is assigned to a superclass reference variable? Subclass object is assigned to a superclass. See here. Concentrate. See, subclass object is assigned to a subclass. Where is that? So okay, here a reference to a variable of a superclass can be assigned to a subclass derived from that class. Means, just remember, the subclass object can be assigned to a superclass reference variable. Okay, what happens? In that case, we'll have access only to those parts of the objects defined by the superclass. See here what happens within this example. We'll see. So we have here int ij and k. K is with respect to b only. If I write here int z, okay. If I declare one variable, for example z. So if I assign here, see, I assigned here, see the super ob dot. See, we are assigning subclass object to a superclass. Now if I write here, for example, system dot out dot println, set value equal to, now if I write here super ob dot check. Now this gives an error. Why? Because super ob dot check. Okay, we cannot access the child specific variables by using a superclass object. Okay, see here. So z is a within a subclass, that is class B. But what we are doing here, it's here. We assigned a subclass object to a superclass, subclass reference variable to a superclass reference variable. Even though we can access only, see, the condition here is when we assign a subclass object to a superclass object, we cannot access the child specific members of a child class. We cannot access the child class specific members by using a superclass. So now if I write here sub object, there is no problem. Okay, but see, because the child is within a subclass, so this statement executes properly. But if I write here super ob dot z, so now this gives an error. Why? Because z is within a child class. So by using a superclass instance method, superclass instance variable, we cannot access the child specific data member. So this is what the condition when we assign the object of a subclass object is assigned to a superclass reference variable. In that case, we'll have only those part of object defined by the superclass. Okay. Next we'll see this is all about the inheritance. So if in the external this question is asked for inheritance, just write the definition. Okay. Next, how to extend a class by using extend keyword. Now mention, write some explanation regarding these types of inheritance. What is single inheritance? What is multiple inheritance? So now Java does not support multiple inheritance, and how to achieve this, just write. And next is just represent with a diagrammatically what is single, multiple, and multi-level inheritance, hierarchical, and hybrid. Okay, just explain these types of inheritance. Next is the general form. So how to what is the general format of creating, extending a class or achieving a inheritance. Okay, next is a subclass includes all see right subclass see pro inheriting the properties means it includes all the members of its superclass, that is a subclass or a child class. Okay, next is it cannot access those members are private. So these are some conditions. So now what is and one more method is how to access the one more point is how to access the data members of a superclass and child class. So now how to access data members we have seen with example. Now how to access, write that point. And next is a reference variable. So how to assigning a reference variable. Now reference variable of a superclass can be assigned to a reference variable of a subclass. The meaning here is we can assign the child class reference variable to a superclass. Now what is the condition here? When you assign, we'll have access only those part of the object defined by the superclass. Now child specific variable cannot be accessed by using a superclass. Okay, next we'll move on to the next topic, that is a method overriding. See, we have seen what is method overloading. So here method overloading is the class which having the same the classes. The method overloading means the method having the same name and different types of the method having the same name with a different parameter list or a signature list. So that is called as the method overloading. So in case of method overloading, the method overloading is the method in a subclass has the same name as the method overriding means this method overriding is achieved within the method overriding is with respect to the inheritance. This can method overriding is achieved within just by using inheritance concept. How now the method overloading is without any inheritance or without extending classes, we can achieve within only one class. That is, method overloading is the meaning of the same name with the different different parameters. Okay, now with respect to the method overriding, is the same name and the type and signature of the method are same. See here, what is the definition here? The method in a subclass has the same name and the type of a signature as the method in its superclass. Okay, the subclass the method within a subclass having the same name and the type of this parameters, that is type of signature, as the method in superclass are same. Okay, for example, we have a method show within a superclass and one more method called as a show within a subclass, and if the type and parameters are same, this the method name should be same and then signature types also same. The number of signature type means the parameter types of parameter and number of parameters same, then we can say that method is overridden. Okay, now method in the subclass is said to be overridden the method in the superclass. So now when the subclass method having the same name and same type of parameter signature, so now that method is said to be overridden within a subclass. Okay, and then overridden method is called from within a subclass, so always refer to the version of that method defined by the subclass.